Greetings. Thank you, Da Truth Channel 01, for repeating another claim from Islam. I'll repeat your claim here and examine it rigorously into submission as I go. No crucifixion in the Bible. This is a common error by Islam, brother, based on Surah 4:157, which you mention later. This is, however, contradicted in the Quran by Surah 5:14. If you want more details, you can watch my YouTube videos. The Quran contradicts itself, Surah 5:14 and Surah 4:157, and the Quran damns Surah 4:157 with Surah 5:14. Matthew 4, 5-10, Satan tempts Jesus, peace be upon him, to jump off the cliff if he is a, the lying holders of the pen, Jeremiah 8:8, changed to the Son of God. I'll address the mention of Jeremiah 8:8 first. This is another erroneous claim by Islam, brother, caused by ignoring the context and torturing the meaning. Jeremiah 8:8 does not say, the word of God is corrupted. If you want more details, you can watch my YouTube video, Letter to a Muslim Brother, 47, The Lying Scribes of Jeremiah 8:8. Satan tempts Jesus, peace be upon him, to jump off the cliff if he is the Son of God. Let's be perfectly clear here, brother. The apostles that Muhammad's Quran calls good Muslims wrote that Jesus is the Son of God, the Son of God. And you need to listen to and understand the two witnesses against your error. First, Jeremiah lived and revealed Jeremiah chapter 8 hundreds of years before Jesus lived, or the disciples recorded the New Testament. So even if we pretend Jeremiah did speak of any corruption or change, it could not apply to anything in the New Testament. Therefore, the change that you make is the very sin you accuse the scribes of. What change, you ask? You attempt to change the Son of God to only a Son of God, a more general metaphorical term. I say again, brother, it is you who change the Word of God, the very sin you accuse the scribes of. Now that refutation alone, all by itself, should show you the ignorance Islam has fed you, brother. Give yourself a moment. Pause the video. Think about how little Islam knows. Islam and its imams do not even know that Jeremiah was written hundreds of years before the New Testament. They have sent you into jihad with your logical pants around your ankles. I am embarrassed for you, brother. But that is only one irrefutable refutation of your misinformation. Second, Muhammad confirmed the scriptures, meaning the Old and New Testaments that existed in his day. So if you insist on calling them corrupted, you are calling Muhammad wrong or a liar. Worse, if you claim the Quran is Allah's actual words, then you call Allah wrong, or worse, a liar. The facts refuting the claims of corruption are many, and too long for inclusion in this video. If you want more details, you can watch my YouTube videos, Examining Islam's Lie, The Torah and Bible Are Corrupted, and Answering Islam's Illogical Claims, number 2, Allah's Unchangeable Word. Satan tempts Jesus, peace be upon him, to jump off the cliff if he is the Son of God. Let's review what is actually written, brother, and I'll explain, tafsir it to you as we go. Matthew 4:3, And when the tempter came to him, he said, If thou be the Son of God, command that these stones be made bread. Notice, my friend, The text actually says, the Son of God. And if you will think about what Satan actually said, you may learn you misunderstand this whole event. If you be the Son of God. This whole test, this whole exchange is around those three words. If you be, if you are the Son of God. The whole jihad only makes any sense if Satan thinks Jesus is the Son of God. Satan's whole jihad only makes any sense if Satan thinks God has a son. Your jihad against the Son of God is not new, brother. Maybe you should ponder why you and Muhammad wage Satan's jihad even now, brother. But he, Jesus, answered and said, It is written, Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. Then the devil taketh him up into the holy city and sets him on the pinnacle of the temple, and saith unto him, If thou be the Son of God, cast thyself down, for it is written, He shall give his angels charge concerning thee, and in their hands they shall bear thee up, lest at any time you dash thy foot against a stone. Satan's jihad remains the same, questioning the Son of God. Only this time Satan quotes a scripture, For it is written. For it is written. This is actually from Psalms 91:11-12. For he will command his angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. They will lift you up in their hands so that you will not strike your foot against a stone. I find it interesting how Jesus answers this misapplication of Scripture in Satan's jihad. Jesus said unto him, It is written again, Thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God. You wrote, Christians want to believe Jesus, peace be upon him, is claiming divinity. I think you and Islam completely misunderstand this text, brother, and how Christians accurately read it. Jesus said unto him, It is written, Thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God. When Jesus said this, he did not imply his own divinity. And no Christian that I know of misreads this that way or teaches that. Christians do not think Jesus said, I am God, do not tempt me. The real meaning, my friend, is that it would tempt God or put God to the test for Jesus to jump and then think, Ha! God, save me, or else you are a liar. Save me, God, or else I prove your word is a lie. Any action such as that, demanding God perform according to how you, or Jesus in this case, reads a verse, is presumption. That is what Jesus was actually saying to rebuke Satan's jihad, my friend. I will not put God to the test by jumping and demanding God save me. Our knowledge Jesus is God does not come from this verse, brother. It comes from 100 other more certain proofs by the prophets. Jesus said unto him, It is written again, Thou shalt not tempt or test the Lord thy God. Jesus said, It is written. So where did Jesus get this from? Deuteronomy 6:16. Do not put the Lord your God to the test, as you did at Massah. So Jesus was not saying, I am God, do not test me. Christians want to believe Jesus, peace be upon him, is claiming divinity. When that is not the case, Jesus, peace be upon him, said it was written. He did not directly say to Satan, You should not tempt the Lord your God. Is God stupid? I've explained your error and the error in Islam's jihad, which also happens to be Satan's jihad, as I have shown. You really should think about that, brother. I know the truth it reveals to me. Telling Satan to remember and uphold the law? Jesus is not telling Satan to uphold God's law, my friend. Jesus is demonstrating how to refute and resist and withstand Satan's temptations. By knowing the message of the prophets of God and applying it. Christians apply the Word of God by following its instructions and its wisdom. This is a big lesson for Christians to take to heart, because many do not know the Word of God. No crucifixion in the Bible, and it is confirmed in the Quran, 4:157. They say they killed the Messiah, son of Mary, but they killed him not, nor crucified him, but he was lifted up alive. Honestly, my friend, you jump to repeating Surah 4:157 as if it follows from your error with Matthew 4. Logically, the two are not related in any way, and your mistake, taught to you by Islam, crushes your whole jihad from the start. Satan's jihad against Jesus was a complete failure then, brother. Just as Islam's jihad against Jesus today is a complete failure. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.